Dear friends, good morning. And today I am in examination room of the brothers of our post-novices. They will be having what we call the De Universa Philosophiae exam. And what is this? They have studied philosophy for the past 2 years, and whatever they have studied in the treatises that will be included in the exam of these already past week, because they've had their written comprehensive exam last week, and today they have their oral comprehensive exams. So please pray for them. And their examination begins at 7:30 this morning, the first one of them. And they'll be going one by one and to be grilled, so to say, by the three professors of philosophy, myself, Father Michael Aguardia, and Brother Paul Dunca. And of course, they'll be asked many questions, and these are questions that really matter, important ones, because they speak about reality. They speak about the questions that are tough and deep. Speaking about questions, in the gospel for today, Jesus was asked by one of the scribes, and a question about the law. And he was asking, which is the first of all the commandments? And Jesus replied, the first is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There's no other commandment greater than these. You know, the situation for today's gospel is ironic. Jesus was grilled, of course, not only in this part, but in the past days we've been hearing about this, these questions that his interlocutors were asking him to test him. That here it is a scribe, and it's very ironic why he's an expert of the law, and he asked Jesus about the first of all the commandments. And the question does make sense, for it can indeed be the question of many who find the number of commandments in the law overwhelming. A study of the Torah would yield numerous precepts. How many are they? Even after the time of Jesus, towards the 3rd century AD, the Jewish rabbis have sought to enumerate the commandments. And the most popular puts the number at 613. Therefore, which is the first of all these commandments? The answer is given by Jesus, and he quotes passages from Scripture. The first one is very familiar with every pious Jew, the so-called Shema Yisrael. And he says, You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. Taken from Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 5. It is the first and greatest commandment, and this is a sure and unimpeachable answer. But Jesus says more, You shall love your neighbor as yourself. This is from Leviticus chapter 19, verse 18. What Jesus does is unique. Why? It's trailblazing because he juxtaposes, putting these two great commandments together. Then he pronounces that there is no other commandment greater than these. We usually know the level of a person's moral development when we find reasons for why he or she follows the law. Some obey the law because they are afraid to be caught and punished, or because they are expecting a reward, material or otherwise. Others obey the law because they know that it is right and noble. It's the right and noble thing to do. And indeed, some obey the law because they know that they obey the law because it is for their love of God and neighbor. The gospel passage affirms the last situation, to love God and neighbor. What should motivate our words and actions is love. And speaking of questions to answer, examination, at the end of our life, after all, that is the question that we would answer. Have we loved God? Have we loved our neighbor? And maybe it's beyond even all the questions that they would be answering in today's exam. Maybe we could ask ourselves also questions. What motivates us in doing what is good and right? Is it love of God and neighbor? What are the concrete ways of loving God and neighbor? And I end this with a prayer, thanking the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for giving us the power to love. Purify our intentions that whatever we do may always be because of love. God bless you all and have a great day. Good morning.